If you want to tell me how old I look in the comments down below, I will let you know if you're right or if you're wrong. If you're good at this guessing game, if you see this, I will tell you this. My body has prematurely aged when I was in my early 20s. So I'm not any younger than early 20s. Tell me how old I am. Or how old do you think I am, at least? And how old do I look? Those two comments. The reason I said that again, honey, is because I'm going to have to delete the other video because I did say my age, and I want people on YouTube to guess. It is currently November. What is the day? November what? 27th or something? Oh, okay. It's 3 days until the first. When I'm lonely, yeah, I know I'm gonna be. I'm gonna be the man I'm gonna be waiting to. And when I'm dreaming, well, I know I'm gonna be. I'm gonna dream of a time when I'm with you. When I do look an awful lot like some family members I have. Feel like I should properly introduce all of my animals, and I will do that in another video. But I have 4 cats, 4 leopard geckos, a hamster. I had 2 hamsters, unfortunately, honey. My old hamster, she passed away of old age. And I have 1 more. I have 3 gerbils, 2 girls, 1 boy. And I have 4 girl rats and 2 boy rats. And that's it. I used to have mice too, pet mice. I miss having little mouses. They're so cute. But we're trying to lower number of animals. And if you can hear the cricket here in the background, that's for a leopard gecko.
Just it?
And again, no one wants to hear commercial. There we go. Pretty sure I'm catching that sound. I'm gonna give me sometime an electric acoustic guitar with a cord and an amp. Well, I have an amp, I need a cord for it. And an electric and a bass. And then I can start back up my music here on YouTube. This is like the kind of stuff I would be singing in the 50s and 60s. I'm a gothic hippie. I'm pretty sure I've said this before, but I'm a gothic hippie. That means I'm either 100% hippie or I'm 100% goth. Today I'm goth, but yesterday I was hippie. I had my jean bell bottoms with diamonds on the back pockets.
and my hippie bell sleeve, long flowing hippie shirt from the 60s and my hippie headband. Like I'm in totally in a dream. My dreams are very vivid, very realistic. It's really weird.
She feels a breeze
coming from behind the medicine cabinet, so she looks behind it and guess what she.
I'm pretty sure I just smeared my eyeshadow. Anyway, I'm very into alternate realities, paranormal, that kind of shit. I'm a paranormal investigator when I, just every day, I guess. And then I'm a demonologist, so I know about those and can tell you how to, I can help cleanse your house. Very powerful pagan, so, you know, yeah, it's just very, very weird because in my dreams, because they're so vivid, a lot of people say that you go to an alternate reality, and I kind of actually do believe that that's where I go when you have vivid dreams like that, because it's so real, you know. And I believe in reincarnation and I believe that I've been reincarnated many times. I can remember clippets of my, of some of my past lives, not all, but some. And I believe at one point I was, in fact, Mama Cass from the Mamas and the Papas because I looked just like her and all of the things that, like, it's just, it can't be a coincidence. In my eyes, everything happens for a reason, so it can't be a coincidence. I've always liked the name Ellie, and I've always wanted my name to be Ellie, and I never knew why. And then I had this boyfriend, and his last name was Cohen, and I could, you know, I always loved the Mamas and the Papas. I always related to Mama Cass, and I didn't know anything about her until I researched her a few years later and realized her name was Cassie Elliott Cohen. So I do believe that I am her, because I've always had the fascination with the name Ellie, and I've always had the fascination with the last name of Cohen. You know, so I do believe that that's one of them, you know?
When the deal's done, you got to know when to hold, know when to fall, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money. When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time enough to count. When the deal is done, you got to know when to hold up. Know when to fold up. Know when to walk away. Know when to run. You never count your money. When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time enough to count. When the deal is done.
I mean, I'm not a bad singer. I'm pretty average, I would think.
Bounty versus the old family dish towel.
I've been told I have a good singing voice, but only when I have music in the background of songs.
That can carry and redistribute food residue.
I can listen to it
for better hand hygiene.
And match my voice to do a good melody. To do, you know. To match. My voice is very gruff right now. I don't know why, but I've been having a lot of throat tickles. I don't know why, but... My ability to sing is very compromised when I'm stoned, so apologies to them, but I think it would be good. I think I sound good. I hope. This is a new kind of weed I'm trying out, so that might also be it. Or I could just, you know, lip sync and it would be better. Oh, that thing isn't on. I love to rock and listen to music. I'm rocking in a not a rocking chair, a glider. It's fun for me, and I like to get stoned, listen to music, and rock, and just do, because like all the like grittiness and like it's just it's like meditation kind of. Well, it sort of is, because like I zone out. I daydream a lot. I will tell you what it is. Having Marilyn Manson own me. And him having complete domination over me. That's what I want. I just want him to, like, knock me around a little bit, make me call him master, you know, and just, like, fuck me, you know? Dude, I bet if, like, I paid him to do it, like, a lot of fucking money, I bet he probably would. But he would, like, need it all in writing and, like, trust me, because I'm a submissive. I would have it all in writing and have witnesses that would sign it and shit. And also do a video consent thing of it, too. But, like, I wouldn't need a safe word or anything because, like, you know, and he's, like, in big legal trouble now. But you know what? If I was only that lucky, because I like that kind of shit. So, yeah. I mean, whether he did it or not, that's still hot, and I still want him to do that to me, because, like, that's hot. He's hot. And I will always consider myself his bitch, even if he doesn't consider me his bitch. I will always consider myself his. His property, his bitch. I would do whatever he told me to do with gratitude. Yeah, sure would. I have completely new photos of Marilyn Manson on my phone right now. I'm so bad. And if you guys know my crazy ass, I would also have sex with Anton LaVey if he were still alive, too. You know I would. And you also know my crazy ass enough to know that I would fuck Elvis Presley, too, if he were still alive, regardless of his age. Because Elvis is fucking hot. And I do believe in the conspiracy that he was still alive and attended his own funeral. I do believe that, but he just recently died, from what I understand. My husband and I were actually able to confirm that by we were given information on it because I'm such a huge Elvis Presley fan. And so, we got some information, and we were able to do some digging, and found out that Elvis actually did attend his own funeral. If you go to Elvis Presley's funeral pics of him in his coffin, he looks awful waxy. A corpse is not going to look waxy. Look up Elvis Presley in coffin, and you will see it. Keep that image in your mind and then pull up another page and type in dead body in coffin or funeral pics or open casket photos. And you will see they don't look waxy. That I believe that the Elvis photo, that Elvis, the one in the casket is a wax figure. I do believe that. Because he looks really, really like waxy, and dead bodies do not look like that. They just don't. So, yeah. And there would be cotton balls shoved up his nose. You could, would be able to see that. There's nothing there. And, you know, it's just not there. Used to make me smile. Go ahead. You'll see what I'm talking about. Go ahead. Look it up.
I could make those people dance, and maybe they'd be happy for a while.
A lot of people are going to think I'm fucking insane, but I mean, I am, but in a good way, I guess. I called Marilyn Manson once. I called his house, and Dita answered when she was back when she was married to him. And I called and asked to talk to him. And, well, I said, is Brian Hugh Warner there? And she said, yes, honey, but I think you're trying to call Marilyn Manson. And I was like, Marilyn Manson? And she goes, yeah, and I'm going to tell you right now, this isn't his house. And I swear I heard Marilyn Manson's voice in the background say, who is it? And she goes, may I ask who's calling, please? And I said, this is Amy. And she goes, Amy. And I said, yes. I swear I heard his voice in the background. But even if I didn't, that voice, and then I heard Dita talk in a video on, you know, and it sounded like the same voice. I know I called his home phone. And then, like, a day later, I tried again because I was thinking that Dita wouldn't be there. And the number had been disconnected. So you and I both know I called him that day, and that spooked them, so they changed their number. You know it, and I know it, too. I've always been a fucking crazy bitch. I stalk him online. I sent him a message earlier, a couple of years back, or last year, that said, amuse me, master. I will do whatever you want. I am yours to use and abuse as you wish, you know, that kind of shit. And the day after I said that, he got into legal trouble, saying that he was, like, abusive and shit in relationships. And then I sent him, like, 1,000, like, apologies and offer for to be a new manager because his manager had fired him, or he stopped working with him. And so I offered to, like, help him out and shit and to get him back out there in the public. And then I tried calling him, and he didn't answer. He wasn't online. I called him on Facebook, sent him messages, and on Instagram, and I'm just worried about it. I know that sounds so fucking weird, but you know what? I am insane. I mean, the domination thing doesn't even need to be sexual with him and me, you know? It could just be him, you know, ordering me around and knocking me around, just, you know. That would be so much fun. I like to, I want him to tie me up, choke me, handcuff me, slap me across the face, backhand me, punch me, push me. Force me to fuck you. I mean, if he wants to, it doesn't have to go there, but, you know, could just be, you know, being tied up, being ordered around, being smacked around, you know? Making me call him master while he calls me submissive. Or bitch, or whatever he wants to call me. Yeah. I don't think I'm his type, though, anyways. He always says he... In one of his music, he says he always fucks the crazy girl. And, that's me. I am crazy. I'm insane, actually. So, you know, most of my friends know I'm insane too. You know, and I only want the best for everyone. The thing is, if you've made it this far, thank you. We're at 25 minutes and 48, 49, 50 seconds. So, I better wrap this up here. Don't want to, but if you've made it this far, thank you. And yes, I have kids. If you want to know the full story, let me know in the comments down below, and I will let you, I will make a whole video on it, and I will have everything compiled. It's a pretty fucked up story, to be honest. I mean, it's real fucked up. So, let me know, and I'll let you know. And also, don't forget to let me know how old you think I am, and how old I look. Please, that's important.